Boeing 737 MAX crashes have led to the company's first annual loss in over 20 years, and, more importantly, caused the deaths of 346 people. Democratic members of the House Committee on Transportation and Infrastructure have just issued a report on the cause of these accidents. In the report, they cite a culture of concealment and say that in several instances, Boeing withheld crucial information from the FAA, its customers, and 737 MAX pilots. As a cultural anthropologist and consultant, I think the idea that culture played a role in Boeing's decline is worth delving into a bit. In the corporate world, anthropology is used in many ways. This includes helping in the design of products and addressing cultural issues within companies. Aviation is an industry where poor design can cause loss of life. Civil aviation is statistically the safest form of transportation because, generally speaking, whenever there's an accident, the cause is determined and measures are taken to ensure that mistakes and design flaws that lead to accidents can't cause others. But the 737 MAX 8 accidents have causes that have actually led to crashes before, even though they're attributed to a new system called MCAS, the Maneuvering Characteristics Augmentation System. Boeing added a system to the 737 MAX without telling pilots that removed their ability to control their planes, and that had a single point of failure. So in hindsight, the crashes aren't surprising because Boeing stacked three factors that could have caused problems on their own. Pilots are creatures of habit because they have to manage complex socio-technical systems repeatedly. So an aircraft manufacturer changing something without telling them can be an accident waiting to happen. It can disrupt a routine or cause a distraction that triggers a chain of events that leads to a problem even when it's not directly responsible for controlling a plane. But the MCAS system was, and even then, pilots weren't told about it. This approach has been responsible for accidents in the past, like Scandinavian Airlines Flight 751. In this case, the pilots noticed their McDonnell Douglas MD-81 had an engine problem and, as a result, reduced their throttle to avoid damaging the engine. However, the Automatic Thrust Restoration System, or ATR, automatically increased engine power, which caused both engines to fail and led to a crash. As with MCAS, ATR was meant to increase safety and added to aircraft without informing pilots. The ATR system was developed by McDonnell Douglas, and MCAS was developed by Boeing. Something else that Boeing did with the 737 MAX 8 was design MCAS with a single point of failure. MCAS relies on readings from an angle of attack sensor that moves based on the orientation of the aircraft and can inform a pilot or another system whether the nose is too high, but they fail sometimes. And most large planes have at least two, particularly because faulty AOA systems have caused accidents in the past. MCAS adjusts the horizontal stabilizer trim to nudge the nose of the 737 MAX down when it senses that it's too high. It could have been connected to two angle of attack sensors because the 737 already has them, and this would have made more sense because they don't always work correctly. But the one Boeing decided to attach MCAS to malfunctioned and caused two airliners to crash within just a few months of each other. This design decision is reminiscent of another that led to the crash of American Airlines Flight 191. In this accident, the engine flew off the left wing as a McDonnell Douglas DC-10 was taking off. The loss of the engine disabled the plane's stick shaker system, which is powered by the engines and tells the pilot when the plane needs to speed up to fly safely. But even though the DC-10 had three engines, this crucial system was only connected to one, the engine that Flight 191 ended up losing. This design decision ultimately caused the pilot to stall the plane, which would have otherwise remained flyable even after it lost the engine and its handling characteristics had changed. Researchers, strategists, and designers often develop design principles, guidelines for what to do and what to avoid when developing a product. And consequences for violating these principles are generally user experience problems. But in aeronautical engineering and design, a poor user experience can be fatal and lead to enormous human suffering. So it's clear that the aviation industry needs them more than most, alongside a culture that takes them seriously and follows them as though people's lives depend on them. Because they do. And it's important to note that some of the issues Boeing is facing now have been experienced by its competitor, Airbus. While Boeing made sure automated systems would never override human pilots before the 737 MAX, Airbus has always taken a different approach. Their systems tend to override inputs from pilots whenever they determine that they're doing something that's unsafe, but to varying degrees and based on certain conditions. As a result, there have been Airbus accidents due to pilots either fighting automated systems or putting too much trust in them. Emails have been handed over to Congress and the FAA that reveal some Boeing employees feared the company was putting people's lives at risk with their decision-making. The Democrats' report cites Boeing's culture as a fundamental cause of the accidents. Republicans on the House Committee on Transportation and Infrastructure also blame culture, but in a very different way.
But we can never eliminate every risk or anticipate all scenarios, no matter how much technology is in the cockpit. Failures will occur. That's the reason why I have stated this time and time again, that the most important safety feature you can have in any aircraft is a well-trained pilot that can fly the aircraft, regardless of what the investigations conclude. Airlines have to ensure that their pilots are sufficiently trained and experienced to handle the aircraft in which they're in. Pilots can master the cockpit's technology, but they have to be able to fall back on their training to fly the plane. That's first and foremost, fly the plane, not just fly a computer. For me, the accident report reaffirms my belief that pilots trained in the United States would have successfully been able to handle this situation. The reports compound my concerns about quality training standards in other countries, and that's why I've asked the DOT Inspector General to look at international pilot training.
It's worth exploring whether it's possible to develop an airliner that won't have fatal crashes as a result of design problems. And it's actually been done. The Lockheed L-1011 TriStar has never had a fatal accident that was attributed to a design flaw, even though it was introduced in the 1970s, when aviation accidents were much more common than they are today. McDonnell Douglas's DC-10 was rushed into service to beat the L-1011 to market. It ended up selling better as a result, but it was also a minimum viable product that had fatal accidents as a result of problems with its design, which were ironed out as incidents exposed them. The L-1011 caused Lockheed to write off $400 million and permanently exit the civil airliner market. Lockheed's culture led the company to design a plane that's as safe as possible, but ended up causing its airliner business, which started all the way back in the 1920s, to fail. Boeing's acquisition of McDonnell Douglas in the 1990s has been blamed for changing Boeing's focus from engineering to cost-cutting by employees who experienced the cultural change. So it's notable that problems involving the 737 MAX have similarities to issues with McDonnell Douglas products. There's clearly a need for design principles in the aviation industry, but cultural principles are even more crucial. Anthropologists work on organizational culture as well as design projects, and there's something that happened with Boeing's acquisition of McDonnell Douglas that's particularly noteworthy. Usually, when a company is acquired, aspects of its culture tend to fade away to varying degrees. The acquiring organization often forces the new one to change in ways that meet its need for better integration. And most acquisitions fail to add the value that's expected, in part because what's lost culturally in this process is often responsible for whatever value could have been gained by the acquisition in the first place. Even though McDonnell Douglas's managerial culture weakened the company enough that it could be bought by its biggest rival, this led to dramatic changes to Boeing's exemplary culture. And now the company is dealing with some of the same problems that caused McDonnell Douglas to lose to them. But before it started crashing, the 737 MAX was selling so quickly that it was poised to potentially gross Boeing $1 trillion. It was on track to be an incredibly successful product. And when the accident started, sales amounted to hundreds of billions of dollars and had already passed the GDP of Poland. The price of just one 737 MAX 8 is over $120 million. And since the accident, sales of the MAX have plateaued to around 5,000. Since understanding cultural issues is the basis for its existence as a discipline, cultural anthropology takes an especially holistic approach to examining culture. Applied anthropologists draw on their field to address problems outside of academia and work as consultants in various industries. Many companies even create positions like chief culture officer and include anthropology in professional titles and anthropological skills in a range of roles. Perspectives from the social sciences and humanities are crucial for understanding human beings and their social systems. This extends from tackling design and organizational challenges to addressing ethical imperatives, like developing economically viable airliners that are also safe, or automated systems that don't amplify the faults of human beings or turn on them. Unfortunately, the need to humanize industries often doesn't become apparent to business leaders until there's a crisis. So hopefully it happens in aviation soon, particularly as automation creates new opportunities and threats. Anthropology is increasingly commodified, but it's crucial that organizations address these issues in ways that go beyond using culture as just another corporate buzzword. The situation at Boeing is bringing attention to problems that many other companies are facing. Because while the 737 MAX crashes resulted from a chain of events, the human errors that set it in motion likely began in a boardroom instead of a cockpit.